Man, my poor little, my tiny little heart, man. It can't take much more. I ain't even started, and your guys are just hurt. I can't, you know, it's just can't. I can't, man. All right, guys. Hello. How y'all doing? Welcome to a Planetary Annihilation tournament where it is the qualifiers for the PA League. And I don't know much about it other than that I was invited to it, and then I saw some messages on Discord, and well, I was very confused because I was like, oh, I have to qualify, but it looks like these guys here are trying to qualify for it, so I don't know, maybe they're trying to fill up slots or, you know, I don't know. Whatever. Yeah, so I was all good, yeah. Let's look around here. Somebody needs to open up some spec slots. Flub River spec slots blocks. Come on. Man, I tell you, these tournaments, they never run smoothly. You need Exodus Esports tournament pack, yeah, for the maps, yeah. These, yeah, tournaments, these never run smoothly. Okay. Now they got me. They got me on that. Never mind, I can too. Alright, so this is gonna be Flub versus River, which I don't know much about River, but I think it's Flub. He spams air, and he's tried his little heart out to convince me that he does not spam air, but actions speak louder than words, my friend, and this guy likes to spam air, and I get triggered every time. So pray for me, guys, because I'm probably gonna get triggered today. Ooh, I like this map. This is the Reef. This one's been around for quite a while. You have an alternative to the Comm Reclaim. Wait, is this a Legion? Is this a Legion tournament? Because the Legion mod is activated. It is primed. Is it just me or does Ted Annihilator sound like he is high? Do I? I guess Jesus has an effect on me. I guess. I don't know. Are you talking about? Sound high. I'm just, you know, enjoying life. You know, I'm happy that I'm not playing. I'll be watching. What was I going to be doing instead? Well, I was going to be playing a game called, honestly, I don't know. Let me alt tab real quick and find it. Particle Fleet Emergence. And if anybody, Jesus, huh? Yeah, what's up, Edlern? So that's how you call it. Hey guys, please don't spam me with sounds and stuff. Don't me. I like it better when I can trust you guys and I give you the option to just make all the things that can go wrong go wrong. So, I mean, I like, you know, it makes me feel better if I can trust you guys. But I was playing this game called Particle Fleet Emergence, which is, if anybody, it's not a very well-known game, but there was a game before it called Creeper World 3. I'm pretty sure it was made by one guy. I don't know, it's an indie game. It's a pretty nice indie game. Anyway, it's a recent one that came out that's like it's spaceships with supply lines and stuff. It's just, you know, it's cool. But yeah, River versus Flub today. We're gonna be watching here. Let me just get a drink of water and be a bad caster and look at my phone. Oh, it looks like it got some Snapchats. All right, hopefully that's nobody sending me pictures of their turds. I get that from time to time. It's quite lovely. Creeper World 3, yes, man. Adler, yes, my man knows what Adler knows what Creeper World 3 is, and my man. He thinks it's really fun. Good man. It is. It's quite great. Couldn't River or Flub just watch the stream and know where each other's commanders are? Well, they could. Let's just hope that my stream delay is slow enough. But this is Flub, the air spammer, versus River. And I will get their names mixed up, without a doubt. Yeah. So, we're going to see probably the most basic stuff. This guy, River, probably just forfeited the game by building that combat fab first, to be honest with you. He needs to have fabs taking metal. He doesn't need that combat fab yet. So, generally, this build is two fabs, then a combat fab to reclaim your commander, then another fab. And right now, he's decided to take a... You see, if you'll see here, I mean, Flub isn't even reclaiming his commander yet, which is right. But this metal here that's coming from this comm, it's probably just... It's floating off into nothingness right now. I'd say it's a bit difficult to micro stuff while watching streams. Yeah, I've tried to do it before in, like, non-tournament situations. Just because, like, one time I was watching Aladea, and then he was on stream, but he had some sick jams, and, you know, my eye did make its way over there, but, you know, stuff happens, I guess. I normally, you know, I wouldn't do streaming or anything. I hardly ever played PA while I wasn't streaming. But Flub over here is poking around with his scout, looking around for things. He's about to fly into some interceptors here. Ooh, nice catch. Yeah, you're right. Because you get, like, really distracted from doing that nonsense, you know what I'm saying? So... not much to comment on right now. Was it River? You know, surprisingly, River's getting out ahead when I was like, well, it looks like a Flub. You know, actually, you know, nothing important's happening right now, right? He went with this first. You know, maybe I'm learning things. Because Flub... Okay, so... Yeah, when I was criticizing, I was like, River was seemingly doing it wrong, but it looks like it is turning out pretty good for him. I might have missed some comp snipes, stuff like that. I don't know. No idea. We're at three factories to four factories. You know, this is a... Here it is. Yeah, Flub is a little bit far behind right now in factories, and this would be about the time where I would be getting T2 up, but, you know, maybe I just need to watch and learn right now. Four factories to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, just some air flying around the map. Flub has 7 interceptors to, River's 4 right now, but it looks like both of them are going mostly for bots and air, which is, well, to be honest, that's just how the game is played at this point. But I'm wondering who's gonna go for the T2 or if they're gonna do some weird things. But the most interesting thing that I'm looking at right now is that Flub managed to start a naval factory, didn't finish it, and plopped another one down. But the interesting thing about that is that if you get your stuff in the water and your opponent leaves it uncontested, then this is just all yours. It's just all yours. This is Flub's right now. That's all River is communicating to Flub is, yeah, this is all yours, you can have that. And when that happens, then about 10 minutes later, you find some kaijus or some leviathans or some other long-range artillery or some orcas exerting control over anything next to the shore. and even further if it's a Leviathan. So River, like, I think, like, right now River is not making the best, not setting himself up to succeed quite so much. Though I would like to see Flub send out these piranhas as they are just sitting there right now. A small little engagement there, nothing really to note. Neither of these guys are really pushing out too much. So it looks like River, he is expanding further into the middle, going to more risky places, and it's, as you can see, his metal income's going up higher, and I still don't see. Okay, yeah, Flub is going for the T2, so I guess he had to make some sacrifices. This is gonna make River really sad if he's looking over here right now. Depending on how this engagement turns out. Yeah, it looks like Flub won that engagement over here, so he is making sure that the expansions are not going down for sure. But they're not doing anything. He didn't give these extra orders. He's not checking these other metal spots, so that's not good at all. I don't like to cast. Well, I wasn't sure because, like, I stopped casting for a while there because I was getting really, you don't know, but, like, I didn't like casting because I would just, like, I felt like I was far too critical about it. Annihilator sounds completely different to me than the last time I watched him. It was all, what? Oh, you guys are talking about stuff? I wonder if I should turn the chat off or not. You know what? Let's leave it there, you know. This is gonna be hopefully on YouTube. I don't know. It would be nice for it to be on YouTube for sure. But, yeah, you know, and stuff. But, I just don't really see much in the way of things to talk about right now. Except that River has made a gambit for the water. But, like I said, Flub needed to have these piranhas going to places because he could be denying this right now. Now River has a chance to start building up in the water, and when you have to fight for that, naval's very costly battle. When you actually have to fight for it, but I mean, this could be free metal. But you know, if River was smart, or either of them were smart, they'd be setting up some torpedo launchers over here and there. And this clump of units has no spinners, and if River would be flying them around and checking things, you would see this and take the opportunity to get a nice, good, just goodbye to destruction of these bots. I can't think right now. But yeah, I like to see it when units are being used for a purpose, being made for a purpose, and sometimes, and this is a problem I've been having as well, because, well, I haven't been playing very much. You gotta play, in order to play this game to its fullest, man, you gotta play a lot, and I played a lot. Oh, it looks like Flub is getting out ahead on the economy right now, which is actually kind of, oh, it's not very surprising, actually, because, well, he's got the water so far to himself, so far so good. He's got an army sitting in his base doing just whatever. He's a little bit further out. He has a little bit more power income, but he is wasting it, or he's not using it efficiently with these air fabs. Though, those air fabs, let's be honest, they're going to make a killing. And as you can see here, metal income is just skyrocketing for him. He's got his T2 economy building up, all that good stuff. River is actually opting to get his advanced power up, even though, I mean, maybe he doesn't know, but he's at a little bit of a metal deficit right now as compared to his opponent. So it's good to see that at least over here, River has set up some orcas. And It looks like Flub is finally going to figure out. Oh, come on, Flub. 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 Oh, come on, Flub. Come on. Just please. Please. Does he know about it? A Flub. Come on, Flub, please. Flub, please. Oh, come on. Okay, whatever. Maybe some bad pathing or something, but like I don't think it's pathing. I think he just clicked in the wrong spot. He checked, but he didn't check enough, I guess, you know. You wanna make sure that you checked everything, you know. Maybe he's probably confident right now that there's nothing there, but he didn't poke far enough in order to see that. But I believe Flub has advantage in air. 4 to, well, he's got 4 to 5, 4 to 4 air factories. No, 5. I mean, he can. I mean, with that number of air, honestly, he can just throw it away. But for both of them, but I would really like to see both of them using their air to scout out these things, because a lot of what's going on can definitely be prevented, and it's not really being prevented. So at this point, I'm seeing just the slow enclosure of river on this map. When you kind of look around here, it starts getting, and this is you, and it's starting to get a little bit claustrophobic. It's time to start pulling out all the stops. But I think both of these players could be scouting a little bit better. But looks like Flub here, not quite sure exactly what he wants to do with these levelers. I'm sure he knew that he needed him. He just didn't know what he needed him for. River is making a advanced naval factory a little bit far, a little bit behind when Flub started his. But if you see here, it's just Pink's Flub's just getting bigger. Actually, you know, this is actually kind of interesting because a good chunk of Flub's economy is in this water, and he's allowed River to get 3 naval factories in this water here. And River has been able to finally contest that. But if he's gonna go for a full-on engagement, he's just gonna lose all these boats. But if he were to go this way, he'd be able to take out all the economy because, well, a sub moves as fast as a sub, so they're never gonna catch up. So it looks like River saw that those extra big tanks, the XL tanks, the double barrel shotgun tanks, or whatever you want to call them, the levelers, and the bolos. The bolos, I don't care what you call it. When I started playing, it's called, well, I don't know. When I started reading the names, I don't know if it was when I started playing. When I started reading the names, he said bolo. Bolo. All right, okay, don't, in before it's an ant, okay? So, I'm just gonna slide that bolo right under your nose real quick. All right. So, let's, you know, probably take a quick look at how we are match one. Looks like games are processing. Somebody just like spam my chat and let me know that I'm taking too long to look at this. But some cool things that we missed in this one was a pretty the dancing docks with the sick cool moves. He did the shimmy. He said that's the shimmy. Or what would you call that? If a dox were to dance and it had names for the dance moves, what would that be? I wouldn't call it a dab, that's for sure. But, you know, cool little thing over there. It looks like where who was it? Yeah, River made the Stitch first, and I'm actually quite curious about this. That he started out. Let's see here. This is kind of looking at the progression of this, see if it made any effect. River was doing quite well. And then right around here, it flipped. And then Flub just went out of control. And I'll tell you, a big part of that was, I think Flub got T2 earlier and started getting that T2 economy up. But another thing was River kind of neglected the water for quite some time. So I don't know, you know, I'll have to go into the lab sometime and kind of see exactly how what time you build your combat fab really makes a difference. But you really don't need it until the second or third, until after the second fab that you put out, because, well, if you wait till after the second normal fab that you build, that's about when you start stalling. So you can sneak out a couple extra metal extractors if you can. So what's going on, chat? Triggered Bolo. And actually, there isn't as much constant raiding, etc. these days. Try playing Flub, dude. Dude, I played Flub, and I was getting so triggered because he wouldn't stop. He would stop raiding. And I didn't like it at all. I was triggered, man. I mean, some of you guys were here. I was perturbed. I don't think I got in a shouting match with the screen that time, but you know, my usual complaints were arising. Check on one of the other matches. I'm not gonna look at any of these other matches. Except for maybe Nicola. Except Nicola are. Oh. Are they playing? Actually, you know, I want to catch up on chat, though. I can't really catch up on chat, can I? I have to be, like, paying attention to things. You sound different from before. How so? Is there another way to watch these, Andreas G? Why? Why is that? I mean, I do realize that it's so much to read. It's useful when you rush T2, but other than that, well, eh. I start com reclaiming like 15% of it, but my building understanding's trash. Well, I mean, just watch some other person play, figure. Are these matches over? It looks like we're waiting. Eh? Is that a match starting over here? I mean, I should just tell them to all leave spec slots. Well, yeah, let's do it that way. Keep laying off until. Well, normally I stop reclaiming when I remember to, and sometimes I don't remember to stop reclaiming, so some of my matches, they end pretty quickly, right around the same time, actually. Most, you know, sometimes, you know, it just goes right over my head. You know what I'm saying? Please. Spec slots. Please! Andreas G. Oh, Alfie and Neon. You know, I can watch this. So these are all going to be on Reef, I suppose. Vape break. Chai tea latte vapor. Ah, like that. Downloading server mods. Can somebody tell me if this is a Legion tournament or not? Are people actually playing Legion in this? Because people are hosting it with a mod enabled, and they're not playing as Legion. Yeah, but we can't do anything about it. Com reclaim is dumb. Yeah. I won't argue with that. I think it just broke the game. Nope, good. There's 16 minutes into their match. And it looks like at some point, you know what? I think I know what happened here. Were there some locusts? No, there was this raiding because these guys don't seem to know the value of putting up a turret. Is this Neon or Alf? That's Alfie. I think Neon'd probably be ahead then. Oh, he's dead. Yeah. Alfie's just wasting time. So I was like, did he make nanobots, locusts, those guys? No, he did not. But he did opt to make Advanced Bot Factory, which is interesting. I would only commit to Advanced Bot Factory if I were committing to an early locust attack and just completely remove the need for T2 eco and just use my opponent's base to fuel my economy. But it is a Legion tournament, but if people don't play it, they don't need the mod. Alright. So far we haven't seen any Legion play, and I would just be looking at it and being like, ooh, that's cool, but it doesn't make any sense to me. Yeah, I mean, locusts are balanced so that instead of needing to have any economy, you can just use your opponent's buildings. I guess the only drawback is that they're really weak. If you can hit them, I guess. Yeah, I don't think there was too much to comment on about that, at least for me, but we could run through it real quick. Let's see. Alfie started out ahead. He looks very convincing in this position compared to Neon. But, oh. Did he have more air? No. He built less bombers though. That's for sure. So it was lobs and Neon was building lobs. He built a lot of air. Dude, this is annoying me. This UI is just freaking out every time I zoom in and out. I mean, I could comment real quick on how Alfie did River and what matches are going on right now? Please make spec slots for all matches. Let's see. I think what lost Alfie this game, and I don't really have to see it happen, but I think what killed him. He was building his turrets further out. What happened? Did he stop expanding? Oh, airfab! I found it! Alfie didn't check for airfabs. GG. GG, well played. Gotta check for airfabs. I wasn't even checking for the airfab, but I saw it. I saw that airfab, I was like, that's it. That's it. Nicola versus Joey Half Rotten Tomato. Who is this guy? Do we know who? Oh, he's a silver. Okay, so it's not like a secret name. Who's River playing? I like River. I didn't get triggered watching him. I'm so bad. Alfie was flub. This is double elimination, right? So he has to lose twice. Please make spec slots for all matches. Yes, indeed. Docs from Lob are slightly more expensive, but the Comrie claim you kind of have much more metal than you normally spend anyway. Yeah, and I don't think it costs energy. If I remember correctly, Lobs don't cost energy. Like, after you build them, it's no energy costs. So, really, you can get away with some really annoying stuff. So, you have to scout it and build a ton of bombers. Otherwise, you get overrun. Baron, is this a good one? I hope this is a good one. Why can you... I wonder what three Hallies would do on that planet. Just out of curiosity. I'm not sure what it would go, what you would aim it at. Build speed is more like 1.5 faster for the bot fact, but also 1.5 times more expensive. And there's no, like, once it builds the docks, it builds the next one. If you notice in factories, there's a momentary roll-off between them that they added in. I think they actually made it worse or made it longer over time to the bot factory because bots were so prevalent because you just poop them out one after. You just keep doing that constantly. It was a source of many a complaint back in the day, 1 year ago, something like that. Economy, weapon, metal consumption, 15 per second, something like that. Are there any better matches to spectate? Oh, wait, that guy's not in this. I'm really trying not to be judgmental right now. He's still reviewing his last game, Alfie. Thank you, Gilgamesh, for that host. That was very, very nice and gracious of you. It is much appreciated.
You like watching me?
It's okay.
Why is it playing it twice? This is making me... It shouldn't do the sound twice. Okay, I'm just gonna casually... No, it's not that button. No, how do I get rid of this without... Okay, duplicate scene 2. I'm gonna rename this scene. No alerts. Oh, wait. Alerts is spelled with an A. Okay. No alerts. Whoops. That's probably a global source. Webcam. Don't need that one. We can get rid of the alerts. Although, thank you for the follow. Thank you all for the follows. I will say I don't cast too much anymore, though. If we, you know what? Planetary Annihilation. Pyramid? I forget what it's called. The Skills Pyramid. Although this one doesn't look like a pyramid. Well, if we just take a quick look at the Skills Pyramid. Let me explain to you a little something about the skills pyramid. Alright, the bottom would be the biggest. These are the most important ones. So the first thing you want to work on is your economy. Ah, dude, come on, man. I don't know how to make it stop. This is going to keep getting these noises. Economy. And then it goes production. And it goes knowledge. And then it goes army composition. And then your build. No. I don't agree with this one. This one needs to go. Build production is your build. I disagree with that. Intelligence. But as you go up here, some of these are a little bit odd to me, but I will agree that economy and production and overall knowledge are the big ones. So you can click back and forth as fast as you want. It won't get you any more docs than you have already. Who is this guy? I see his face all the time. I just don't know who he is. So that's the planetary annihilation skills pyramid, if anybody's interested in that guy. Oh, no signal. My Xbox must not be on. Good thing, because I'm not. I was just clicking randomly to, you know, have things happen. I was like, right, sure, you know. So, I don't know who this guy is. What is this? Okay, thanks. Be right back, lol, Xbone. You know, it's too late now. We are starting. You are starting. Are you playing Danzo? Is Danzo your opponent? Am I in the right match? Oh, you are playing Danzo. Arcjoy, so none of these. Disc Rape versus Acroxian? Oh, dude, all these are one-sided. Maybe I should want. I don't know. This is like the tournament. This is the grand finals map. What is this doing in round two? This is the map. This is the map, man. This is the best map in the entire pool. This is the way Planetary Annihilation was meant to be played, at least for me. When I think of Planetary Annihilation, I think of a big barren rock with just lines and lines of factories with a stupid amount of units just doing so much stuff you can't even keep up with it. And this is the kind of map that facilitates that. So, on this map, you get, like, a really big starting position. You generally don't want to land there. Okay, so who else is playing? Hopefully they left spec slots, because... yeah. Okay, so we have... yeah. Marshall's casting this one, too. I hope he won't mind if I jump in. Hopefully they didn't start. Sorry about that, folks. That guy started out building metal extractors and... Well, let's just save ourselves some trouble.
So
this one is Nicolo versus Joey Rotten. And they're actually well into the, they're, was this a late game? A late starting game? This is actually Legion versus Legion, which is kind of interesting. Nicolo versus Joey, half rotten. So, I'm going to be honest with you, I've really, you know, I know that the units are kind of the same, but not really, but it looks like Nicolo has actually done a fair job of doing things. I'm having trouble here finding the chrono cam. So we already know who won this one, right? So let's look here. Oh, dude, I just see these foreign characters on the screen. It's just like, it's hard. How did they start out? It looks like Nicolas started out with the Comm Reclaim and Blue didn't. Alright, we have one other match to watch. Nicolas won that one. Ooh, so it was Flub. We have that last one with some Platinums. These guys are still on Reef. So we'll go ahead and see how this one is. I think one was Platinum and the other one was Bronze. Oh, not an eventful round, folks. I'm sorry. Things in PA chat. Things in PA chat. Well, smoke if you got them. No, seriously, though. Smoking's bad for you. But vaping is supposedly not as bad for you, but I wouldn't take my word for it. I would do research. That's just the general consensus of people that vape, and I haven't got a clue. How legitimate that claim is, to be honest. But I'm just gonna fill up my juice because I kind of got a little bit of, I think I got a little bit of that cotton taste. And I'm trying to atomize. I'm not trying to get that combustion of that cotton. No siree. So we have Legion, and we have Acroxian, who's a Legion player, and Disc Rot, whatever that name is. So we're looking at another one that is currently in a thing. Oh, those are the losers round. So Nicolo versus Flub. Has that started? Is Flub here? It looks like they're just kind of going as they come on it. Nicolo versus Flub. What's the other one? Neon versus... Oh, they're waiting on this match. When are they going to start? Is Nick M... Wasn't Nicolo and Flub going to start? Because it looks like this match is actually way far behind. This is round two, and Nicolo and Flub are over in round three. Okay. So, we're not going to watch this one in its entirety either. Okay, so looks like he plopped down the wrong factory first and off to a convincing start here. We both have factories down. And undoubtedly we will see a Faber. A Fabbly Babbler. You can pretty easily keep your commander from moving, which is generally what you want to do when the game starts, is plop the power generator, like, not where you're gonna build it. I mean, not where your commander's at. So if you guys see me, I'll plop down this guy, and I'll plop down two power generators, and then I'll plop down an air factory. All within distance of my commander's build range, but not far enough that it can't. I mean, not close enough that it'll just start walking around and being indecisive. It looks like Disc Rape. Is that how you say his name? Is probably gonna need to put down some more power generators. When you build Fabries, you generally want them to do something. So the next one, and it looks like they're in the lobby, Niccolo versus Flub. If I can find it. It's a big F river. Match 5? Why are these? So, is this match started or no? Looks like they're setting that up. So, what's up, guys? How's life? Cost and build power is about the same. You guys haven't been talking about nothing, have you? I'm just gonna scroll up here and just look at the chat. No, it's called a bolo. All right. All right, you're wrong. Undefended power one. It's over there. I don't see it. Show me memes between games. You know, that's a good idea. Here's a meme. I'm hashtag Nick has to restart the game or something like that. Okay. I didn't mean to type that I, but you know, it doesn't hurt to be cute every now and then. Alright, I'm going to be back in a minutos. Honestly, I don't think that's even a word. In a minute. BBL lol. Yo. Sitting in the morning early. Don't know how to rap or freestyle. I'm watching some PA and talking about it. What's up, River? You ready to make this planet fall? Reclaim like timber. I've got limber. Been practicing all night. I'm a rapper, so I have to feel so great about myself. I'm in love with me, nobody else. That's why I vaporize. That's why I vaporize, because there's nothing to do between the maps. That's why I vaporize, I vaporize, I vaporize. That's why I vaporize. So, we are going to watch Nicola versus Flub, and honestly, I don't care how long they wait in this lobby so that these other guys can catch up. It looks like that match I just noped out of is still going. So I guess, you know, check Facebook for a minute. Nothing. Oh, dude, it's a spider. Oh, dude, spiders are so cool. Dude, spinning that web. You know, I wonder how long it took to spin that web. That is a big web. I know you guys can't see it, but, like, dude, spiders are cool. You should, like, look up spiders sometime, because just, like, watch them make a web in fast paced. I don't know. When it's sped up. Why do I have two? That's why I have two instances of sounds coming from OBS, because I have two instances of OBS going. Oh. So we have Flub versus Nicola. And I guess my little freestyle there was wrong, because River's not in this match that we're watching. But it looks like we see bot first. We'll see some bot fabricators and some combat fabs. And then we'll see some bot fabricators probably. And then we'll see some docks. And we'll see some power gens go down, of course. And then we'll see some air factories. Nicola is having delays. They are having connection issues. Which is not very good, because that's going to affect his performance. It looks like everything is out to a pretty fairly equal start, though. Flub will be ahead here in just a moment, because he started closer to where his metal spots are. Or at least had his fabs come out closer to where his metal spots are. So his fabs are going to be doing some walking, as you see here. Here in a minute. These numbers aren't adding up. Come on, numbers. There we are. Numbers. Flub's ahead, and he's going to be ahead for a while there, unless something changes. This is kind of an awkward map. Like, what if they both started right next to that? They'd just be kind of, like, giving each other the stare down, you know? So, excuse me. Nicola has opting for two air. They're both opting for two air. It looks like these guys, you know, I like to get my T2 up by my fourth factory, or to be my fourth factory, but not everybody plays the same. A little bit of air jousting going on here. Nothing too great to note, unless a bomber got shot down, and then we can talk about that. I keep opening up the wrong tab. But if you see here, if he made a bomber, Nikola did make a bomber, he would have less interceptors. And if he has less interceptors, he loses the engagement. And if he loses that first engagement, and they both have an equal number of air factories, then Flub will always have more air than Nikola for the rest of the match. But it looks like Nikola is... I don't know how to say his name. It's Nikolai. They both are making air fabs. I think I saw an air fab. But it looks like Flub's air fab already got shot down. It's better to send your air fabs to a less obvious place, to be sure. Because, you know, it will get scouted. But, like, where that air fab, obviously, what he wanted to do was make a gambit for the water as fast as possible. But it's not that big of a deal, to be honest. Because eventually these two fabs can make their way over there or do certain things. But if I look, yeah, it looks like they're not really actively scouting anymore. After that first engagement, they both seem a little bit comfortable. Except that, well, Flub noticed that his docks got seen, so he's gonna go reinforce them. But I don't think Flub knows until right now that he's getting outproduced in air for the time being. Nikola is opting for T2 bots, which is interesting because if you I don't know if this is like the best decision based off the information, if this is what he's thinking. But bots do have a couple long range units that he can use to pester his opponent. But I don't know. Flub's expansion looks pretty strong up until it stopped expanding. Nikola's gonna catch up on the eco because of it. Though it looks like most of the attention is going on in this lake, because if you lose this lake, you're gonna lose the game. More than likely. At least that's my thoughts about it. Though Flub has more energy, he has a higher capacity to spend his eco. He's a factory ahead, but that's only because Nikola is making a T2 factory right now, which will make a difference. So I wouldn't take this deficit in factories too strongly. But it looks like, yeah, he's going to have a T2 economy a little bit later than Nikola. And it looks like he's making some torpedo launchers, even though there's no boats to shoot at just yet. But, you know, it's a good thing. Flub is behind for the time being. It would just be nice. Okay, yeah, these fabs are doing their job. I want to concentrate more on this air. I want to actually go back and take a quick peek, because there have been little sorties. It looks like Flub got backed off when he saw this air force. I don't think he even took the time to see if it was an equal engagement. If you have a smaller air force and your opponent's not looking at his air and it's not moving, by all means, just kite a little bit. But from time to time, I see this air not doing anything. It looks like Nikola is indeed struggling with the lag, which is not good. But Flub missed pretty big opportunity there, because he could have, if he had been a little bit more bold, he could have gotten a good trade on the air, probably. And maybe, I don't know, could have happened, you know. But the main thing is, could have got these air fabs, and these air fabs are gonna just do damage. And if this air is making its way over here, he can shut down this expansion. So when I was looking over here to see this torpedo launcher go down, it would actually, like, if he would have had the information, he could have actually made the decision to put this in a more bold, put the torpedo launcher in a more bold spot to where it could actually deny the building of a naval factory instead of deny the aggression that will undoubtedly come from it. So, the things that we're going to be looking at the things that we're going to be looking at right now are who's going to get their T2 economy up and how well Flub's going to be able to take advantage of this naval factory. It's not looking very good right now because it's not rallied anywhere. Nikola crunching up his air. I think that probably got a bad engagement on that. I don't know. But if these docks were, say, right there, yep. Yeah, that can get denied. And if he sends out these docks, actually, if we look at the land for a moment, we'll see that there's a lot of potential aggression that could be going on Nikola because he's not setting up turrets. If, say, a small doctoring party came over here to destroy these, there's at least that bare minimum of defense. But it would have been stronger if he put up a wall in front of it, to be sure. Another thing I'd like to see is a radar, which I like seeing. That's very nice, because now he has a little bit of layer of intelligence over there. So, Nikola's putting up some mines, I suppose. He's got that Mines of Strips mod going on here. It's good to see, though. I don't know, I don't really have an opinion on it, to be honest. I just think it's more convenient to have them in lines of two or three. You like seeing radar? I like seeing with my radar. Well, did you think that comment was going to go under my radar? Well, if you did, you're wrong. I absolutely do not like this decision that Flub goes for every time to get the T2 power up first. But that's just me being very nitpicky. I don't like that decision, though. So what I'd like to see right now is Flub to have... There we go. That's nice. And what's going on? So, this water has not been taken advantage of. Oh, it has. I mean, he's just making a killing off of this water. I'm just saying that he could be setting up some T2, but an advanced naval factory over here. He could be setting up some orcas or building some things of that nature and putting these in a position that can actually deny, which he is now, but... He's had to deal with some things a little bit late. When did this get built? So they both have two T2 factories up. This thing's been up for a while. Like, I would not be happy to see this. When did this go down? Only recently. But... Flub does seem to have... I can't really tell when they're clumped up like this, but I'm going to venture to say that Flub has more air than Nikola, and he's definitely was being more attentive about it in that situation. Nikola's being very reactive with his air, and Flub is putting in the time to make it, like, pay attention to his air when he remembers to. I would just absolutely love to see both players' air being more active, Because this is going to be, by far, your most important tool of intelligence behind or along with having radar. And I don't know, when I look at this with the Flub never going for this metal in the back, he's kind of... I mean, he can't have it now, but he's given up a good line behind his base up to all sorts of meddling things like Wobs and Rocketeers or whatever, Blue Hawks and Pelters and all manner of annoying things that just make you inwardly burst eye blood vessels in your eyes. And Nigula is making Shellers, and these guys don't believe me when I tell them, but I'll tell you this. Shellers are not that great unless they're being used as a support unit. And if you have Shellers, you're going to want to have Spinners and be protecting them with your air and all those sorts of things. I'm trying to see here what exactly. Flub is getting that T2 metal in his base. And I'm trying to look for his this guy's fab. He's going for an advanced radar right now. Though I believe he is stalling on energy already. I think that's what this indicates. And honestly, this map is really small, and with two radars, one here and like one over here, maybe three or four if you really already have the map control to take advantage of it, you can get away with four radars and still get as much information as you would out of the advanced radar, and it would cost a lot less, because if we look over here, advanced radar is a drain of 4,000 versus this small guy 150, that's all you're paying for. So not only can he not really afford to build this right now, he's not going to afford to power it. And there are much more simple, easier solutions to go for. As while he's dedicating much needed time building T2 metal to building a radar. Number one priority is going to be his economy. And Flub here, I still don't agree with these advanced energy plants, but Flub here, as you can see, slowly devastating Nico's base now with this catapult, which actually is doing a lot of good work. But Flub here is also making an advanced radar. I would just really like to see both these players building more metal extractors at the T1 and the T2. But Flub does have a solid lead, though he should have manually told these units to go wherever they're going, because they're going so slow. Maybe he did, I can't really tell. Yeah, now they're speeding up. Now he told them to go somewhere with the... just causes slowness to happen. I'm waiting over here. It looks like this is going to get cleaned out with the levelers. Higher leveler count. It's a pretty done deal. Not sure how this force of slammers got to be so big over here, but this lake is never going to be contested, ever. Nicholas gave up that privilege long ago, though with some little bit of cleverness he could have probably pulled it off because Flub was not being putting his units in the most aggressive positions to deny. All he can really do is hope. Yeah. Actually, I was going to follow that up with something, but that's about sums it up. Nikola is less than 50% of the map right now. Really, he's got this sphere where he has influence over it, but he's running out of options fast. He is concentrating on T2 metal for now, but it looks like it's a pretty done deal here. I would like to see this advanced factory build things. I would definitely not like to see a T2 air factory. But he's, at this point, the economy difference is really doing the trick. And there's a lot of things that went into it that you might not have necessarily have thought about, but I can tell you this, that this game has a lot to do with exponential growth. So if you start out not growing at all, and you've already lost against a player who did start with growth, but like when you're over here and both players have an understanding of the general game mechanics already, it's gonna be in those small things, and it's gonna have to do with your priorities. What do you prioritize? Flub prioritized an advanced radar. Nikola prioritized a strong economy, and Flub's in the position where he has a lot of intelligence, but he's not necessarily able to power it at all times. And there's not much information. He's low on units. I'm sorry, Nikola. Nikola was the guy. It was over here. He prioritized this. And now what you'll see is that he has less units. Oh, hi. Flub is a girl. I thought he was just a young boy. But Flub definitely likes to build air. Though we didn't see the extreme this time. Should've spammed Locust, bruh. Flub is a 12-year-old girl. Confirmed. Does it matter? Ugh! What's up, fellow? Ugh! These guys are triggering me. You should've T2 Dable earlier. I would agree with that. Let's check Facebook real quick. Nothing fun going on over there. I don't know when I lost air control. That pissed me off quite a lot. You lost air control when you built a bomber. And Flub built nothing but interceptors. I think that's how it went. That was a... Yeah. Yeah, because Flub was in the lead with air. And it just kind of stayed that way, mostly. I'm sure, though, some early Locusts could have gotten control of the water back. You know, you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. See, when I see Advanced Bot Factory, what I'm thinking is like that right there should probably end up making Locus and a T2 fab, but you can get away with not building the fab and just Locus because Locus will just give you free money. For sure, like, did Flub build piranhas? They do a decent job at keeping the locusts away. Yeah, I can't. I'll also say that his tech choice and his use of his tech, the really hard-hitting units that come out of the bot factory weren't really built. Except for, like, the slammers are the hard hitters, but the locusts are the game changers. I didn't notice that Nikola built a lo Hulkins. Unfortunately, that could have used quite a bit of more defense from the air, but yeah, that was probably another thing. He didn't really have the hard shell of defense required to keep that Hulkins alive. 10K metal gone. Yeah. Yeah, this thing's floating away, puts PDs in water. I've had to. When I was at my prime, I had to. Because that's all Kizipco would build, dude, was Locus. He'd always build Locus. Stopped playing so much because I got angry even when I won. It's a good thing I took a break, I think. Oh wait, did he respond to that? No. Okay, so I should probably take a look over here and see exactly what the plan is. Because if there is no plan, then, well, what are we doing? I am waiting for the next match. It's Neon. We're waiting for Neon to get in the finals, I think. Nicola River versus. See, I would hop into some of these matches, but. I guess. Might as well take a look. A quick look-see. See how these guys played out the map. Just. I don't know how to say that name, but it's. To me, it sounds like it would be read as Disc Rape. I'm trying really hard not to say that name. Trying really hard. Although, in order to explain that, I'm trying not to say that name, I kind of had to, say it. I might experiment with emphasis on tactical missile launchers and either anti-air turrets or anti-air units. Turrets are always your best bet. You can win by building nothing but fabs. I mean, and mass-producing air factories. It's a combination of those two. Okay, so over here. Neon is actually getting a run for his money. In this situation, we're 16 minutes in, and yep. Well, purple has probably won this. Neon's not moving his cat, his commander away. Okay, there we go. There are some mines. I don't see a skitter to see those mines, but if these units advance into the base, they will wreck Neon. So what I'd like to see out of this one is the use of rally points, because it looks like he's just letting his units stack up in his base and then sending them off. Units are a lot more useful when they're in a position to cause damage, that's for sure. I think Neon could still win this one. Oh wait, no, he's not in the water. That's the other guy who's in the water. Yeah, he's unfortunately lost his T2 vehicle factory and a good chunk of T2 metal. This is not looking so good. CSG is this. Just platforms and things that are in the way. Stuff like that. They're map decorations mostly. But this is, I was actually, you know, expecting Neon. I was expecting to see Neon doing better. He's a longtime player in PA community. I know that for sure. He is. He is running away right now. Run, little guy. Run as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. Honestly, I wish Neon would. Yeah. Yeah, he's gonna have to struggle to get his power up so that he can just put everything in the building defenses and getting his economy back up. And he's gonna have to do a lot of cheeky stuff with micro as well. He's gonna want to clear out all these docks before he engages with us with the boom bots or catch him out of position, which he did. And it's probably gonna want to know if there's a bunch of barracudas waiting for his commander in the water. And I would just really like to see Purple here do a little bit more actively taking advantage of the complete control he has over the map right now, really. Oh, yep. Dude, what is this? We can actually see the water? I didn't even know the water had textures like that. Dude, guys. You never see lighting like that in the water. I guess you do. I didn't know that there was a texture down there. Everybody say hi, texture. Saw texture. Stop being such a hipster. You know who you are. Look at that. Why is that texture so much more interesting than this one? You can't even see it. Maybe it's just interesting to me because I haven't seen it before. Or paid it much mind. But we will have T-Scrape versus Flub. Yep. Once again, everybody, this is a qualifier tournament for the PA League, which I will be participating in, I think. I've been giving it much thought. I've been invited. I've been assumed to be participating. I have definitely been giving it thought, though. Because I don't know how badly Wait, why is Nikola sending me an invite to... What? I'm not watching this match. What are you doing? Why you do this to me? I just saw the name and I clicked it. I'm gonna be watching the grand finals. Unless we're waiting... Invited to the attorney, never said no, so they assumed, yeah, so edgy. Yeah, no, that's what Andreas did. He assumed that I was playing. Which is a good motivator for me to play, but... I don't know if my heart can handle it. I don't know. Do I really want to compete again? I'm like super edgy and sarcastic and just, you know, sometimes it's just my heart's not in the right place. And I don't want to do it if my heart's in the wrong place, you know. It's not about me. I'll make it about me though. This isn't about me. And that will obviously show up in my attitude and the entertainment value of actually watching if I'm being a dickhead. Alright, lobby's up and ready, but I don't want to watch that one. Frozen Oreo yogurt, but I want to... When is... Flub and this... playing, or when are, oh, bad vocabulary usage there. So Frozen Oreo yogurt has a lot less metal on it than I remember. And I don't think it's because it's changed. Legit tournament game. I don't think it's because the map changed. It's just because I remember it having more metal. So, is this the... I just don't... Flub set up lobby things and stuff. It's actually Frozen Oreo Yogurt. I love the name of that map because it looks like Frozen Oreo Yogurt. Straight up. It's no lie. It is no lie. So, this is the grand finals. And I'll be right back, lol.
why I vaporize, I vaporize, I vaporize.
What song is this? It's a rap beat I'm working on. Doesn't have a name yet. It's actually... I didn't have to put a lot of time into it because it's a rap beat. which is why... I mean, it's really simple, but, like, the guys who wanted to rap on it was like... Every time I make them a song, they're like, ah, it's too complicated. I feel like I have to sing over it. And I'm just like, and I tell them, or I ask them, what? I mean, if you want literally what I told them, it's just like, this is what I said to them. What? What? There's actually an alternate version to this. And I can't find it. Yo, Q-Zip! Guys, you know what? Now that I think about it, I don't know if I should be participating. Because I might have to play against Kazipko, and... I just don't like playing him. He hurts my feelings. He bombs my Fabbers. He sends Locusts into my base. I mean, he's so mean. You're signed up for Division 2 now, Annie. Why is that? What's the difference between the two? Is that Q-Zip is division? Are you for real? Do you give me purple nurples? Pretty much, dude. And he gave me mind purples nurples. Purples nurples. You know what, Q-Zip? You may be able to bomb my Fabbers. But can you do this? Can you do this? Hold on. See, I can do things too. I can do things too, Kazipko. I can do things. On a guitar? For real? Dude, you play- What? Oh, Kazipko, my brother! My bros! Yo, when are you gonna come over to America and we can, like... We can play, like, some co-op or something. We can co-op guitar, you know? Oh, wait, they call that jamming. When are you gonna come over to America and we can jam, man? My man plays guitar. Wait, where do I land? This map's bugged. Oh, I'm casting a tournament. Oh, man. Hello, 911. What's your emergency? We have multiple shots fired. I'm just gonna casually vaporize. Casually. Why you post YouTube videos? Prelude to Loot Suite 4. Do you play that? Can you play that? Whatever that is. I don't know what it is. I'm not going to play it right now because I'm recording. And this entire thing is just going to... Yeah. Vape Nation. Dude. Andreas. Do you vape? Who here vapes? Because I vape. I just got it a couple days ago, and I've just been like... I've been vaping nonstop. This is a problem for me. I went through like half a tank in 2 days. And that's when I was building up the wattage. So we have Flub versus Discrape. I really don't want to say his name. I enjoy the stream so much more than Marshall's stream. Why is that? Why is that? Feed my ego. Hey, wait, no. Let's not talk about that. No. I think me and Marshall are unique individuals. And I think Marshall has much more stamina than I do. When it comes to tournaments, to be honest. So far we're kind of seeing a mirror build. But one thing to note is Flub has built that power gen pretty far away. So his commander's going to be walking quite a while. But this Discrape has... His commander's going to be walking too by the time he puts on the third factory. Because he went, like, what I like to do now because of the comm reclaim is your commander really doesn't have to take the metal spots. So you can get away with just, like, landing in some remote spot. In a remote spot relative to the metal so that you have more space to actually build. Because Marshall sounds tired. What time is it for him? Isn't he British? What are they? 8 hours ahead, and it's like 8:30 here in the morning. It's getting late for him. I don't know his life though. I like Marshall because he has the voice of a caster. And I have the voice of a guy who's high on life, I guess. So I'm not really going into too much detail here, but I would say I think Flob is ahead. Oh, he is ahead. Same amount of factory, same amount of fabbers. Flob, not using his air. What I'd like to see Flub doing is either using his air to attack or putting in defensive positions right now, because this is the point where there will be bombers coming and you'll be wanting to, you definitely want to be putting your air in places where it will be useful. And he needs to scout and defend the fab. His air is defending that fab, and I don't even think that's the point. But consistently, what the fuck? Okay. It's like, what? How did, what? Okay, so, sorry for the language. Trying really hard to fix my mouth up. But, dude, if that air was where, you know, it could have been useful, it would have been useful. Flub... He just lost his air fab. I think he's freaking out right now because he's definitely not scouting. This is the thing about these water maps. Or any map with like a place where you normally wouldn't check for something. You need to check where you normally wouldn't check, because Flub is, you know, I don't see him being in the best position right now. Though on a map like this, it's not nearly as difficult to get a presence into the water. But this is the important place to have your presence in the water. This is where all the metal is at, back here. And the rest of it is just going to be just huge engagements with docks and stuff like that. And Annie, can you cast my bronze tournament, please? No. No. So it looks like Flub is actually he is going ahead and making a very concentrated effort to get into that water, because I suppose that he knows that it is very important to not lose that. Not lose control of the water. Oh man, it's just so. It's so painful for me. When I know the big picture. Oh, okay. Yes! Okay. We're good. So Flub has built a lot of air. Now, Flub always builds a lot of air, though. That's nothing new. But he has 4 air factories to his opponent's 3. He is going to be behind on the T2 metal, but this is one of the more concentrated maps with metal in your base and Purple here will definitely be able to get some T2 metal up in his base before Flub, and he won't be having to fight for most of his metal nearly as hard. But if we look over here, I think, yeah, it looks like Flub's been doing a pretty good job harassing everywhere else around the map. And this is a big map, like, to compare it to the smaller ones, this probably has, I don't know, like a percentage, but when I look at this map, I think it's pretty big. It's not like huge, but it is pretty big. If you guys know like the difference between huge and pretty big is, which you probably don't because it's subjective, but yeah, this is pretty big. So there's a lot of things going on. And Flub has, so far, denied a good amount of expansion, at least to further out reaches. Like, if this is the zone of control, it's about there. And Flub, his fabs have actually just about all gone uncontested at this point. Until Purple here will eventually move these docks around or see something, and then at some point he will find out that there's a bit more expansion going on by Flub than him. And there's 3 naval factories to Purple's 1 over here, and it's actually not, Purple's isn't building anything. See here. The T2 is going down for pink for Flub. I just don't want to say that word, man. It hurts my fedora. My fedora senses. So there's a huge amount of air just flying around. But they're flying places, but they're not necessarily flying anywhere. I would love to see these guys use some shift click commands. If you hold down shift and queue multiple orders, I would love to just see the air flying around aimlessly over places just to check if anything's going on. And Flub is probably, yeah, he's building bombers now. He knows. He knows at this point, especially after that engagement, that he has air control, and he's just, at that point, he gets to be nasty with it. And it will definitely spiral out of control at some point when he can start really being offensive with his air. So some odd engagements here and there. A small force of levelers. But once this gets scouted, Air Force goes over, bombs them. Oh, I wouldn't be too worried about it. Some docks running circles, well, running right through a line of levelers. I'm looking for things to talk about. Ooh! So, one thing Flub has definitely neglected to do this game, which I thought about but didn't really make a comment on, is that this match, he's not really putting too many turrets down. And it's important, especially in the water, to have a bunch of torpedo launchers, because that's about the only effective way to deal with sub spam, which obviously there's not a lot of sub spam, but I'd like to see more radar speckled about the place so that he knows about these things before they happen, not as they happen. If we've seen a theme in this match from both players, we've seen reactions as they happen. Well, I could say, really, we've just seen a bunch of reactions when it comes to a lot of air. There's not a lot of proactivity. These guys are mostly just scared that their comms are going to get sniped or something, I guess, with this current meta. But, I like, right here, if you look, this guy's building a Leviathan. It's going to get destroyed. It's going to attract the attention of all these Barracudas, which should already be going over there. So this T2 factory potentially could have never got built. With this size of a navy, this could be gone. It could be long gone. So I guess the biggest problems I'm seeing here between these players is how proactive that they are with what they have with their resources. But purple is just a small dot on this map right now compared to Flub, I feel like. When you start seeing people get metal on your side of the map, you should know that they've been expanding hard. And here it comes. This naval expansion is going to be long gone very soon here. Interesting decision on the building of a T2 air fab. Not quite sure where it's going to go. But I wouldn't be so confident to build that thing until I have complete air control. But this air force is going to come over here and react to these bombers, or to these subs, which then Flub is going to react by sending his air force over. I mean, if you know that your opponent, you should know that your opponent's just going to send his air force over and just have yours there. Probably. Unless they have a bigger air force, and then, I don't know, you know, got to do some fun little fiddly things. But at this point, Discrape has been wiped out of the water except for this air fab. Now, once you have air control, what I like to do is just fly circles around them. Put units in positions where they can see things happen and not just kind of come across it. I would really like to see a lot more intelligence going on. Well, gathering of intelligence, you should say. There's a very sizable force of levelers over here, which might, like, I would feel very scared in this position. Well, not in this position, I suppose, but he's going to get blindsided. I would feel very, I don't like having blind spots. This isn't a comfortable position to be in. Though, once this comes over, of course, it's going to get bombed into oblivion. Why are you not paying attention to the glitches of the map? What glitches? This is one of the less glitchy ones, to be honest. I just really, ooh, man, where's that air at? It's not even taking care of these levelers. I potentially have to watch two or three more matches of this. Okay, so. Or one or two more. Is it a best of three or five, the grand finals? By the way. Since you're here, Prolert. It's good to see that they're moving out with their air, but Flub just builds so much air, man. And he's gonna lose so many extra fighters for clumping it up. But, you know, you can just do that at this point. I really feel like this is just waiting for Flub to win. So I'd like to see him just continue taking metal around here. I like the kaijus over here. I'd like to see his units more spread out because of this stuff over here. He would have found it if they were more spread out, especially, and I would definitely be worried about another drop into the water of naval. Don't let your naval be contested. When you can have something for free, why not just take it? Take the freebie. Make sure that you keep it. If your opponent has T2 air, you have to go T2 air. Really? I've never felt like that. So, looks like purple's trying to go. Like, at this point, looks like he just wants to try doing snipes. Maybe, probably. That's how it's looking. I should fill up this water again. I'm a little bit parched. So, this is hopefully going to walk up here and clear out just whatever is left to be found. How is this Air Force doing? What is this Air Force doing? There we go. There we go. All right. I was wondering when it actually hit. So, I guess at this point, Flub needs to build some anti-air around his commander, which he has done. Probably keep his air force around his commander, or just do a flyover, the guy's base, because it really doesn't matter. He has such a advantage in the amount of air that he has. Looks like he finally found those metal extractors in the water. He has such an advantage in air. I would just fly over and clean that out, so I don't have to worry about him trying to snipe me. If you can save yourself some trouble, do it, man, because there's a lot to pay attention to in this game, and there's a lot that you can do to manage the amount of things that you will have to pay attention to. It doesn't have to be frantic. I like to make it frantic when I play. I love playing frantically, but the when you pay attention to the bigger details, you can optimize that, and then you can free up your attention to do all the fiddly things. Looks like he got wrecked. Finally. I think he wanted to go for one last snipe. So, does anybody know, is this a best of three or best of five? That classical guitar thing, I'm going to save. I'm going to send myself a link. Trying so hard not to be negative. Send myself this link here. Eventually. Here we go. Now I can watch it later. Prelude from Lute Suite 4. John Williams. Update your FMod libraries to fix sound issues. Will be included in next update. Well, that's pretty nice of them. Include that fix. River versus Neon. This one's probably going frantically. Legit tournament game. We just looked at that one. So they have the Allegiant expansion on. I don't see this game up quite yet. So, I suppose we just did that. No, it's still there. He's still there. It looks like they haven't bothered setting up the lobby yet, so. It couldn't possibly be a best of one. There's a losers round 4 and 5. How does that work? Me now. Also, it was only. That was only. Alright. I didn't know. I did not know. I was expecting it to be like a best of 3 or something. How finals usually go. Don't zoom in before the game starts because it crashes. Titan Azeel PA1 NRX. How do you even say that? I wonder if the game ended or something. No. I'm actually in that game right now. It's registering me as being in the game. I should have hit reconnect. Maybe I can jump out. Jump back in again. Was this guy right? Yeah, I can't watch it. Ross versus Maxi Fish. I don't think that's part of this tournament. VRX or Pain? Oh, VRX. I think I played him. So, well, we have our winners. We have Flub, who just got himself a place in Division 2. He won the qualifier tournament. I thought there was an easier way to do this. If you close these, oh, it wasn't. Usually when there's a tournament, it just says join PA tournaments. You know, I've been watching all day. Maybe I should play one. Oh, wait, because Zip goes watching. I can't. Crap. Division 1 is not set in stone yet. So, is there going to be another one? Probably. I was told Matisse got invited, but I don't think we'll see him. He's probably playing another game. Who am I kidding? Should I put that on YouTube? Do you guys want me to put it on YouTube? I'm gonna go ahead and end the recording.